Hi, and welcome back to fDi in the Sky. St. Paul's is chiming, the sun is out, the birds are singing. It's a little miraculous here in London.
Well, this is actually our regular series where we'll be discussing the latest trends in foreign investment. I'm Alex Irwin-Hunt.
I'm Sebastian Shehadi.
And in this particular episode, we will be discussing historic UK real estate and digital challenger banks.
Once again, I've been playing about with our database, fDi Markets, and we found that last year, 2018, saw a historic 15-year record high of greenfield foreign investment into the UK real estate market. It's an impressive figure. It meant 89 big projects into the country. These were large undertakings, totaling 14.8 billion US dollars. In terms of CapEx, that figure was the highest since 2012 and the second highest since 2003. Whatever the metric here, project number or CapEx, it was a historic year for greenfield foreign investment into the UK real estate market. Underlying that is the fast growing rise of office space and flexible office space providers and foreign investors. So 51 of our 89 projects last year were into that space. We've already talked about how last year and going on into this year, the most active investor is WeWork, Spaces and other co-working space providers. So that's definitely underlying this trend.
That's very interesting. Is there anything else underlying this trend?
Brexit's playing a role here. I've talked to foreign investors in getting into UK residential and commercial markets, and they're saying that, of course, the pound is cheaper. London remains attractive regardless of Brexit. These are long-term investments, and Brexit will come and go. And of course, local buyers and domestic players are more hesitant these days. Brexit is very much a boon for foreign investors into this space here in the UK. Anyway, let's talk about European challenger banks. Alex, what's the data trend and highlight?
Sure, again, I was looking at our database, fDi Markets, and since 2014, eight particular European challenger banks have invested over $800 million in 30 greenfield fDi projects. Now, this is amazing. This has been across 18 countries, across many continents, Europe, North and Latin America, the Middle East, and Asia Pacific. The interesting point here is, what are digital banks? They've emerged over the last few years. They're essentially providers of app-based banking services, including current and business accounts. And while there are examples all across the world, especially in the US, I've found that European banks, digital banks, have been the most active in terms of greenfield investment.
Great, and is there any country in particular where you'd like to showcase?
The UK has emerged as somewhat of a hub for these digital banks. There are many examples. This is perhaps not a surprise, since that London is one of the financial hubs of the world. Examples of digital banks in the UK are Revolut, which invested in 12 separate projects since 2014. Monzo, Monese, Starling Bank, there's many examples. There's also examples on the continent. There's Berlin-based N26, which invested $385 million into 9 separate greenfield fDi projects. There's also Munich-based fDor. Finally, there is a Finnish example, which is Holvi, which has invested in 3 separate projects. I think the point here is, as consumers and businesses move towards more digital banking services versus the services that are offered by incumbents, I think we'll see more of these investments in the future.
Thank you, Alex. And thank you for watching this second episode of fDi in the Sky. You can watch, listen, read to more of our content at fdiintelligence.com. Until our next episode, goodbye.